When you see a few strands of your hair on your towel, do you automatically go into panic mode and start looking for solutions? Well, there are many blogs, online remedies and home remedies that are giving their own solutions and tips about hair loss. But the problem is, the hundreds of cures are filled with many myths that might scare you even further. Hi, I'm Dr. Nikita, a consultant dermatologist at Oliva, and today I will help you clear all the myths about hair loss. So let's begin. Myth number one, your day-to-day stress is causing you hair loss. This is not entirely true. Though major traumatic stress and pressure can be linked to hair loss, your day-to-day stress is not hair loss worthy. And even in very few cases that it might happen, the hair loss is just temporary. So the next time you have a big exam coming up or your boss is not approving your leave, do not worry. There won't be any hair loss. Myth 2. If you wash and shampoo your hair too often, you will suffer from hair loss. Again, not true. You washing your hair and shampooing it daily won't result in hair fall. If you see some hair strands while shampooing, it's not because of shampooing. They would have fallen out anyway. You just see all your fallen hair together while washing, and hence you are led to believe that washing hair often causes hair loss. Myth number 3. Vitamins help to promote hair growth. No, they don't. Neither taking vitamins nor rubbing vitamin lotion on your head will help you in hair growth. Hair is a dead tissue and vitamins cannot help you in hair growth. Myth number 4. Wearing hats and caps daily can cause hair loss. People say that if you wear hats regularly, you are covering your hair and not letting them breathe, and hence your hair falls. No, the fact is that hair takes its share of required oxygen directly from the bloodstream and hence will not affect the hair fall in any way. Myth number 5. Hair loss is common in old people and men. Hair loss does not discriminate between men or women and young or old. If you have a history of hair loss in family, you may start seeing the initial signs in your 20s. And speaking of genders, as much as 40% of women suffer from hair loss, even though the kind of hair loss experienced by women is different than that of the men. Myth number 6. Hair loss is permanent. This is not entirely true as well. In case of male pattern baldness, the condition is genetic and is permanent, and this can be treated through non-surgical procedures like PRP. But hair loss due to other causes like major stress, illness, disorders can be reversed and are temporary. Even for women, postpartum hair loss usually cures itself around 6 months. There are many myths lurking out there, and the best way to deal with them is by consulting an expert dermatologist.